Sunday mornings, you hear Deacon strike out with,
give you glory, because of who you are, I give you praise.
Come on, you try. Christ. Say, Lord, I worship. Lord, I worship you. Come on, you be the choir. Y'all hold on. Y'all hold on. Y'all. This the choir today. Come on. Lord, I worship.
Sampson Street, Third Ward, Texas. We in here today amongst all of these Wheatley Wildcats. We in here today. Yeah. Amongst all these Wheatley Wildcats, we in here. Y'all know how we used to do it at Jefferson Fieldhouse. Yeah, we used to couldn't sit together when we was in there, but look at how we're in here today together. We serve a mighty God. And I just want you to, I want my class to stand so you can see all of this red and this gold. Amen, amen, amen. Sister Potts, we in here. We in here, Sister Potts. Amen, amen. Thank you, class, for supporting me on this day and standing with me on this day. Y'all just don't know what I've had to go through over here, but I thank God that you are all in here today. And like Sister Morris said, 50 years is a long time. 50 years. We toiled through the storm and the rain, but we made it. Yeah. Millions didn't make it, but thank God, those of us in here today, we made it. Yeah, 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 yeah. God is still in the blessing business. Yeah, now we really celebrate next Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, but we wanted to come in here today so we could just show y'all how good that crimson and gold looks. Yeah, 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 yeah. We can't, look at, we sitting on purpose. We sitting on purpose. The lion is sitting on the wildcat. And oh, by the way, Sister Cynthia, I think we whooped y'all last night. I had to eat it last year because I say Yates came on this side of town and we lost all games. But guess what? We've swept the north side this year. Thank God. Thank God. Again, class. I want to thank y'all from the bottom of my heart for you being in here today. And I want to also wish one of my classmates, Valerie, this is her birthday today. Thank God that she's still a Valerie. Yeah.
This on today with my class in here. I want to thank him for allowing us to do this today. And I tell you, I'm just full all over. I'm just full, but I'm gonna let the flow go. But I can, you know, really, you know, I can really tell you, Sister Davis, you know, I really can talk, but I ain't gonna say nothing. You can say all that. Look over here.
Come on, give God praise. I just want to say two things before the women come back to lead us in worship today. Number one, Wildcats and Lions, we do have Harris County on the premises. Amen. In case any of y'all have a flashback. All right. We're prepared. Amen. Secondly, I want to say that it is an honor to have you worshiping with us on this year. And our schedules were a little twisted because I was away preaching on last week. It was my intention to have Pastor Lewis delivering the message while you were present. And so we're gonna have to work it out for y'all to come back. And when you do, you'll get a chance to hear your classmates standing and proclaiming the word of God. Amen.
Before I do the breast cancer portion from yesterday, and we are working on your things being personalized, but I want to announce our trunk or treat winner fourth place winner. We had four vehicles in our trunk or treat on yesterday, our fourth, and these were done all by judges. The fourth place winner was the disabled vehicle. Was Nightmare Before Christmas. It was the Nightmare Before Christmas. They were, I think that was Sister Tanya, right? I think, and she's picking up her daughter today. Let's be in prayer with Sister Tanya Franklin. Her daughter had a baby. The baby was born only 1 pound. Mother is coming home today, but the baby has to remain. They said to Elisa by January. So let's remember the Franklin family today. Amen. But she is the third place winner. Our second place winner. Our second place winner was Get Caught in the Wheel of Jesus. Just gonna wave, get up on the stand, so people get caught in the wheel of Jesus. And our first place winner was the Barbie Club. We did have the pumpkin patch, and let me see, do I see her? We only had one pumpkin yesterday, so is she here? I can't see, I've lost my glasses. You know who you are. The pumpkin patch. She must not be here.
She's not here.
Okay. All right. So we had one winner for that. Yesterday was absolutely phenomenal, amazing. We had something for every age level on yesterday. Is Sister Lazard here? I can't see. Sister Lazard. We had some. So stand, Sister Lazard, so they can see you. Stand so they can see. Sister Lazard was on a horse yesterday. We had something for every age. When I saw Sister Lazard come climb up on that horse, I said, Deja, that has got to be a photo. Well, it was already a photo when Karen Thomas was on there. At this time, really quickly, today we are honoring our breast cancer survivors as well as those that have gone on to be. So we just want to recognize them and present them with their sashes. We did this last Saturday, but because today is our closeout day, we want to do an encore. Amen. So we just bear with us. Those that are here, we want to let them know how much we love them. Amen. Our first breast cancer survivor of 5 years is our own. Oh, that's right. I'm so sorry. I'm getting ahead of myself. As I do it, the names can roll. They can be rolling. They're on there. Sister Lakeisha Parker, 5 years.
Yes, we did.
you, Sister Jackie. We honored her on last Saturday. She was one of our special guests, but she is here today. I did not know that. Mildred Johnson, which is Jackie Overshawn's aunt. She is a 2-year survivor. Listen, these are the names that were submitted to me. I don't want to overlook anybody. Is there anybody in our congregation today that is a breast cancer survivor? I saw a name before. Could you just shout? Come on. If you don't mind coming up, we want to celebrate you. Unfortunately, I don't have any more statues. Want to remember those that have our heroes. Amen. We want to remember those. So when I call your name, if you would come forward, okay. Tierney Copeland will be standing in honor of her mother.
May your troubles show that you need God, and may your battles end up.
Sister Lily, if you would come,
and may your bad days
move. Glenda Sims,
God is
if you would
good.
Come, Glenda's gonna
and
too.
May your whole life.
Jennifer, if you would come.
God is good.
Tiffany, if you would come.
Keep you.
Sister Jackie, if you would come right back.
And may your troubles show that you.
Gayla Johnson, she here to get home for your mom. Is Tamisha here today? I can't see. Stacy, if you would come. Sister Judy, if you're here today, if you would come. We honored Sister Laura Bell Hyder on this past Saturday. Pam was here to stand in for her. But Sister Lewis, we know that y'all were good friends. Do you mind coming to hold the candle on behalf of Sister Hyder today? And what I don't want to do is leave anybody out. Again, these were names that were pre-submitted. If you're in our congregation today and you have a loved one that has gone on due to breast cancer, we have plenty of candles. Would you come and stand in their honor? So now, if y'all would just kind of turn to the altar, because now we're leading into our altar prayer. And just come a little, fill in. Y'all can scoop down some as we honor our heroes this morning. It's prayer time. It's prayer time. And as we reflect and remember, can you dim the lights back there a little bit so our candles can shine? And if you wish to just hold a candle, we have plenty up here. You can come and get them in the basket. We invite you now to come to the altar, because it's prayer time. Come and support these that are up here as they remember their loved ones. Remember their life, their legacy. Remember what they meant, the love, the laughter. And now we invite you to bring your issues to the altar.
For meeting our needs, Father God. Thank you for being a need meeter, Father God. Lord God, as we stand before the altar, Lord God, we thank you for waking us up this morning, Lord God, with a reasonable portion of health and strength, Lord God. God, we come this morning around the altar just to say thank you, Lord God. Lord God, we thank you for your plan of salvation, Father God. We thank you for Jesus who hung, bled, and died for our sins this morning, God. Oh, how we thank you, Lord. And then we come this morning, Lord God, just asking you for forgiveness on today, Father God. Forgive us for anything we said, done, or thought that was contrary to your will, Father God. And God, we ask you to strengthen us, Lord God, that we'll be able to live lives that's pleasing in your sight, Father God. And then, God, as we stand around this altar today, Lord God, we lift up those that are standing around the altar, Father God. Lord God, and because we know that you are a need meter, Father God, we ask you right now to begin to meet needs, Lord God. Lord God, we ask you right now to begin to heal hearts, Father God. Lord God, we ask you right now in the name of Jesus that you would touch, Father God. Lord God, we don't know the specific needs, but God, you know, Lord God. Lord God, we just thank you on today for this service, Lord God. We thank you for every woman that's participating here, Lord God. We thank you for our pastor, Lord God. We thank you for an opportunity to be ministers, Father God. Oh, how we bless your name on today, God, because you're so, so worthy on today, God. Oh, how we thank you and bless you on today, God. Oh, we bless your name in the name of Jesus. We say thank you, Lord God. Oh, God, we say hallelujah to your name, Lord God. Oh God, we say thank you for being a wonderful counselor, Father God. Oh God, we thank you for being long-suffering with us, Father God. Oh God, how we love you, we bless you, Lord God. We ask you to continue to bless the service, Father God, that it will be all that you would have it to be, God. Bless those that are standing around the altar once again, Father God. We thank you, we love you, and we praise you. praise you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Experience to introduce for the very first time our adult praise dancers. Would you pray for them? Would you clap your hands as they come?
You did not create me to fall.
create me to worry. You did not create me to fear. But you created me to worship.
Come on, how many believe that today? Jesus is real.
sound like two or three of us. How many really put it all in God's hands? Come on, how many only here today because you put it in God's hands and found out that no matter what you need, God is able? Hallelujah. God, I bless you. God, I bless you. God, I bless you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do me a favor, stand and turn with me to the gospel according to Luke, the 8th chapter. While you're standing, can you give the Lord a hand clap of praise for the women of Worth Ministry today? They've done a phenomenal job of leading us through service, and we give God praise. Now do me a favor, there's a sad dog that don't wag his own tail. Can you help me and give God praise and worship for my wife, the first lady of our ministry, Lady Rita C. Morris. God bless you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. That means she's going to fix my plate when we get home. Amen. Amen. Luke chapter 8. Luke chapter 8. I want you to meet me at verse number 43, and we'll conclude at verse number 48. The Gospel according to Luke, chapter 8, verse number 43, and we'll conclude at verse number 48. When you have it, say, I got it. If you're still looking, say, wait for me. I'm waiting. Luke. It is in the New Testament, Matthew, Mark, and the Gospel according to Luke. Amen. I'm reading from the New American Standard. No matter what version you read, it should sound something like this. And a woman who had a hemorrhage for 12 years and could not be healed by anyone came up behind him and touched the fringe of his cloak. And immediately her hemorrhage stopped. And Jesus said, who is the one who touched me? And while they were all denying it, Peter said, Master, the people are crowding and pressing in on you. But Jesus said, someone did touch me, for I was aware that the power had gone out of me. When the woman saw that she had not escaped notice, she came trembling and fell down before him. And declaring in the presence of all the people the reason why she had touched him and how she had been immediately healed. He said unto her, daughter, your faith has made ye well. Go in peace. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God shall stand forever. For the time that is ours to share together, I want to speak from the thought, desperate moments call for desperate measures. You may be seated. Presence of our God. In 2003, a mechanical engineer and avid mountain climber named Aaron Ralston found himself in a desperate situation. While descending the Blue John Canyon in southeast Utah, some rocks began to slide. And Ralston found himself pinned down underneath an 800-pound boulder for 127 hours with little water and no means of communication. It seemed like Ralston's life was over. He came to the conclusion that there was but one way for him to escape. With his left hand pinned down, he reached in his right pocket and found an old, dull, rusty pocket knife. And began to amputate his left arm with his own hand. I know that your situation is not as desperate as his situation, But I just believe that I'm in the church with some people that have had their back against the wall. And you know that when it comes down to it, that desperate measures need to be made when you find yourself in a desperate moment. When you have a month with no money, that's a desperate situation. When you have children that have gone astray and you don't know where they are, that's a desperate moment. When you don't have a place to lay your head or a car to drive, that's a desperate moment. When you go to the doctor and they don't have no cure for your condition, that's a desperate moment. But can I encourage you that sometimes desperate moment calls for desperate measures? The gospel artist Katina Mann says it this way: truth is, I'm tired. Options are few. I tried to pray, but where are you? I'm all churched out, hurt and abused. I can't fake it, so what's left to do? She came to the conclusion that when you are in a desperate moment, that sometimes you need a divine intervention. And I wonder, are there two or three people, and I'll make four, that went to everybody you know but couldn't find the answer? But in the name of Jesus, whenever you get in a desperate moment, he knows how to go to desperate measures. I'm not going to hold you long, but I want to share some principles with you, and I'll get out of your way. Let me give you a little background on the story. This woman with the issue of blood has been in this condition for 12 long years. Some of us have been in ours for 2 weeks and we already want to stop going to church. But this woman has hung in there with God for 12 long years. I call that a perpetual condition. And is there anybody other than me? I'd love to tell you that I prayed one time and God took it away. But some of us been praying over and over again, year in and year out, and we are now in a desperate situation. But I tell you, don't give up on God, because God won't give up on you. He knows how to work out your situation. I feel like preaching in here today. Here's what she did, ladies. She did something unconventional. We know that based on Levitical law, this woman had an issue of blood, so she was considered ceremonially unclean, which means she had to wear all black. And if she went out public, she had to have a bell in her hand and ring the bell and yell out, unclean, unclean, so that everybody around her knew that they could not come near her. This woman was not supposed to be out of the house, but she heard that Jesus was in the neighborhood. And how many know that faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God? And the only reason some of us are here today, it's because we heard what Jesus can do. How many heard he was a way maker? How many heard he was a bridge over troubled waters? How many heard that the Lord was able to turn your situation around? She was disenfranchised. I wish I had time to dig into that, because what she was discovered is that she could not even touch her own family. That she had to have one couch or bed that she was relegated to. She couldn't hug her children as they went out to school. She couldn't comfort her husband when he came home from work. She was ceremonially unclean. But the Bible says, although she shouldn't have been outside, when she heard that Jesus was in the neighborhood, that she went looking for Jesus. Can I just tell you, every now and then, you gotta abandon protocol and learn how to go after God. Every now and then, you gotta supposed to say, is there anybody here that had to abandon protocol? She's disenfranchised. But not only is she disenfranchised, but she's disappointed. If you read the synoptics, you'll find out that this woman has gone from doctor to doctor, but nobody has been able to heal her condition. I wonder if she's by herself, that somebody in here has had a problem, and you went to mama and mama couldn't solve it. You went to daddy and daddy couldn't solve it. You called your friends and they pressed call deny. But how many know when you call on Jesus, it can be late in the midnight hour and the Lord will show up and answer your cry? She's disenfranchised. She's disappointed. But she's also determined. For the Bible says, she sees Jesus afar off and said, if I could just touch the fringe of his garment. She understood, because people were pressed around Jesus, that this unclean lady had to press her away. She had to say, excuse me, I gotta get to Jesus. Excuse me, sir, I gotta get to Jesus. Is there anybody here that's that determined? That come hell or high water, I gotta get to Jesus. If I got to go by myself, if I got to cry my way there, I made up my mind that I got to get to Jesus. Is there anybody here that won't let nobody stop you? Come hell or high water, I gotta get to Jesus. This. Y'all be seated. Here's what I love about Jesus. In reality, the woman has an error in her theology. She does not really want Jesus. She really want what Jesus have. But how many know that sometimes, even in our era, God knows how to give us grace, that even when we were not looking for God like we should have been, that the Lord honored our faith? I'm taking too long. She did something unconditional, unconventional. She came, although she was not supposed to. She touched the hem of his garment. And the Bible says, immediately. Oh, y'all don't know when to shout, because y'all ain't been going through nothing for a long time. But when you've been going through something 5, 10, 15, 20 years, and you've been asking the Lord how long, ain't you glad that one touch from Jesus, that what you've been suffering with, that the Lord can stop it immediately? Find you a neighbor and tell your neighbor, that means right now. She did something unconventional. Number two, she did not go unnoticed. She tried to slide in and get a blessing without being noticed. But the Bible says that Jesus said, wait a minute, somebody touch me. Hold on, Jesus. Everybody is crowding around you. What do you mean somebody touch me? Can I tell you the tragedy that many of us press to God's presence, but we don't know how to access his power? I wish I had two or three witnesses that can testify that when I touch God, that I feel the power of God. That when I come in sick, I know how to get well. That when I come in broken, I know how to be mended. I don't just get to his presence. forward and tell you, ain't it good that when a crowd is surrounding Jesus, that the Lord knows how to still recognize the one? That this church can have 250 people in it, but the Lord knows how to deal with little old you. That when you walk in just as you are, from the wrong side of the track and the wrong neighborhood, with no education and no job, that the Lord can overlook the multitude and say, I see the one. I got a question for you. Are you the one? Are you the one? Are you the one that the Lord is gonna answer? Are you the one that the Lord is gonna bring out? Are you the one that the Lord is gonna heal? Are you the one that the Lord is gonna employ? Are you the one that the Lord is gonna bless? Are you the one that the Lord is gonna bring out? Are you the one that the Lord is gonna bring over? Are you the one that the Lord is gonna bring through? I'm going to my seat. But her triumph, watch this, became an opportunity to tell her truth. You don't see it. The Bible says she begins to tell Jesus her whole story. I know why y'all ain't shouting, because y'all ascribe to the Beyonce philosophy that I woke up like this. But if you really tell the truth, some of us ain't get here where we are on our own bootstraps. We had to go through some trials and some tribulations. You ought to stop letting people think that you looking as good as you look, because you ain't been through nothing. But I've been through something and came out on the other side. You ought to tell your whole story. I got joy in my heart, but that don't mean that I didn't go through some hell. I got a smile on my face, but that don't mean I didn't have to cry sometimes. I got a leap in my feet, but that don't mean that I wasn't sick sometime. But I gotta tell the whole story. Find you a neighbor and tell your neighbor, you see my glory, but you don't know my story. The Lord done for me what nobody else could do, and I owe God a praise. Why do I act like this? Cause I owe God a praise. Why do I lift my voice? Cause I owe God a praise. Why do I give him my all? Cause I owe God a praise. Is there anybody here that's ready to give God what you owe him? Stand to your feet, lift your hands, and tell the Lord thank you. For every mountain you brought me over, for every trial you brought me through, I gotta say thank you. I gotta say thank you. She didn't go unnoticed. But watch this. She did not leave Jesus unchanged. Watch this. And I'm going to my seat, I promise. Two things should happen when you come in contact with Jesus. Number one, he should change your identity. I wish I had a witness here. The Bible says she was a woman who had an issue of blood 12 years, which means we do not know her identity. She is identified by her issue. And y'all know us black people know how to do that. Oh yeah, that's the woman that lost her job right there. That's the one who husband left her right there. That's the one that had cancer right there. That's the one that got laid off right there. But the truth of God is that despite my issues, that God knows how to change my identity. You ought to tell somebody, I know what they said about me, but look at me now. My hands look new. Oh my God. Okay. I told you two things. That's one. To change your identity. But watch this. He also changes the woman's destiny. He says, I know you came in pain, but I don't want you to go back like you came. He says, you came in turmoil. You came in disappointment. You came with your body racking in pain. Gonna lose your mind, but Jesus says you're not going back the way you came. You came in pain, but you're leaving in peace. You came in bondage, but you're leaving free. You came confused, but you're leaving with clarity. Is there anybody here that'll give God praise that you don't have to leave like you came? And because Jesus is a good father, he gave us an example. One Friday, he was dead, sleeping in the grave. But how many know that he didn't stay that way? He stayed in the grave all night Friday. He stayed in the grave all day Saturday. He stayed in the grave all night Saturday. But early, I wish I had a church here. But early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hand. You heard of black power. You heard of white power. You heard of atomic power. You heard of aquatic power. You heard of nuclear power. You heard of man power. You heard of horse power. But there's one more power. He got all power in his hands. Say yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah. I know he's alright. I know he's alright. Oh, that feel good. I know he's alright. Desperate moments calls for desperate measures. Sometimes you gotta do something uncomfortable to get to a place of change in your life. Sometimes you gotta abandon the routine that comes with religion and say, I want a relationship. Sometimes you got to do something you've never done before to get something you never had before. If you always do what you always done, you'll always get what you always got. But every now and then you got to step out on faith and say, Lord, even though I don't see it, I believe it. Desperate measures for desperate moments. Maybe you're here today. And you've been stuck in a routine. As I preach, let's take the floor. You've been looking for something different. For as long as you can. God is working in your life. But you're ready for something more. You don't want to leave the way you came. If that's you, you ought to come. Hallelujah. 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 Because I know people. Somebody in this room is saying, Pastor, I'm coming next week. Can I warn you that you don't have next week? In fact, you don't even have tomorrow. The only moment you have to put your hand in God's. Oh God, I bless you. Oh God, I bless you. Come on, he's waiting for you. This is your moment. You thought you came to celebrate Women's Day, but in reality, God calls you to a fresh start. Would you come? Sister Bingley to sit right there. I don't want her to stand too long. There may be others. There may be others that want to join with this august body of believers. There may be others that are like the woman with the issue of blood. You've been dealing with something way too long. But today, I believe that by touching Jesus, you can get an answer to your problem. If that's you, we want you to come. If you've been stuck in the same old thing over and over and over again, it's almost like you're riding around a circular racetrack, recognizing the landmarks day after day after day, and you're ready for a deviation in your situation, we want you to come. Hallelujah. 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 Oh God, I bless you. All right. How many are here for membership? If you're here for membership, just raise your hand. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And Sister Abby comes. If those that are for membership would prepare to go along with Sister Ebony, would you come here for just a moment? Hallelujah. Come on, give God praise for Sister Kathy. Now this one been moonlighting with us for a while, singing in our choir and blessing us. We're grateful to have her today. Come on, let's give the Lord praise for her, Sister Green. Amen. 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 If you would go along with Sister Ebony, she will get all of your information and get you ready to be a part of the body of Christ with us. Amen. Amen. So now, for the rest of those that are standing for prayer. Hallelujah. Yes, ma'am.
First lady to pray. And she texts me every day. I'm checking in, I'm checking in, I'm checking in. And I told First Lady this, and I'm glad this. A lot of y'all know me from younger. I had weight loss surgery, and I lost 300 pounds. But what comes with that is I had no idea that food was an addiction. And so when I no longer could be addicted to food, the doctors kept saying, be careful, because it's a transfer of addiction. It's going to go to something else. I'm like, nah, not me. I started drinking heavy. So heavy that I was in the hospital so many times about my pancreas. And then last time he said, you come back here with this pancreas, you gonna die. So I gave it up, and the first thing that happened when these ladies was telling me how they was getting put out of their houses and losing their cars, they couldn't send their kids to daycare, it was just so much. The first thing my mind said, dude, if you was drunk, you wouldn't even think about it. So one day I was standing at the stove. And I was just standing in front of that being wine cooler, and I was just like, you know, they said, pay you Wednesday, they didn't. They're going to pay us Friday, they didn't. And you know, it was just like so much. And I was standing there, and First Lady texted me and said, I'm just checking in. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
She has been out for quite some time with surgery, and the Lord has allowed her to be in our presence today. Can we give God praise for the fact that our God is a healer? Come on, y'all sitting down like you've never been sick and went through surgery. God done something. And he's worthy of praise. And we thank the Lord for her and her husband for being by her side. If you would do me a favor, just stretch forth your hands towards these that are at the altar. Father, we don't need to know what's wrong with them. But you know, Father. Father, we pray right now for your divine intervention in every issue that concerns them, Father. Father, we pray now, God, that whatever they need, that you would begin to pour it out on them, Father. That when they find themselves lost, Father, that the answer would be found in you, Father. Father, we pray now that you would give them renewed strength, God, that they would be able to stand against the fiery darts of the devil, and having done all that they can to stand. Father, we thank you for the saints that surround them, God, that continue to call their names out in prayer, even when they don't know it, Father. Allow us to be such a family that prays together to the point that lives are changed and mountains are moved for your glory, God. We thank you and we give you praise for what you've done, for what you're doing, and for what you're going to do. It is in the mighty and matchless name of Jesus that we pray and we ask it all. And the believer said, amen. Come on, give the Lord praise. Hallelujah.
Our final remarks for this morning. Let me just say to the Women of Worth Women's Ministry, what a marvelous job you all have done today. Whether you sung in the choir, read a scripture, sang a song, or you showed up today, to God be the glory. Amen. For the things that he has done. October is always a busy month for us. Fifth Sunday is Women's Month, and it always just falls that way. And so we thank God for every woman, for every seed that you've sown, for everything that you have done to make our women's ministry a success. I cannot do what I do without you, but most of all, I cannot do what I do without him. Amen. At this time, on Saturday, as our leaders are coming, please quickly,
We're far past time. Normally, fifth Sundays are longer than normal, so we apologize. You know, women, we do too much. I'm trying to find out how to condense it down. But I make no apologies, because when God gives vision, He certainly gives provision, and He certainly shows Himself strong and mighty. Amen. To the class of 1973, again, we are so grateful that you chose Second Mile Olive to worship with us today. Seriously, we're grateful, grateful, grateful. And to the young lady with the reoccurring cancer, we declare and decree, according to the word of God, that you shall live and not die. Jehovah Rapha, God, our healer, you are healed in the name of Jesus. Jeremiah said, God, is there anything too hard for you? Nothing is too hard for him. So we praise God. I'm going to look forward to honoring you next year. So Pastor Lewis, help me remember, next year during our breast cancer surviving, we want to be able to stand and say, I had it tough, but I came in touch with a man named Jesus. Oh. Hallelujah. At this time, on last Saturday, and this is so unscripted, so unplanned, because last Saturday during our offertory period, the Lord just quickly, and I'm the type of person that when He speaks, I listen, I move. And He spoke to me that we were going to sow into this Angels Surviving Cancer Inc. Because I am on social media, and I am friends on social media with Sister Parker. She posted that she was going to be on a radio station. And so I said, let me listen and see what this is all about. I had never even heard of the organization. And so I listened, and my heart was so impressed. This organization does so much, offers so much. And I tell the women, one thing about us, we are committed to mission, we're committed to outreach, and we're committed to being that beacon light. And so after hearing about what this organization does, their mission to promote an atmosphere and environment of inclusiveness for the lives of breast cancer survivors and their families. Families include their spouse, children, and significant others who are part of the survivor's journey to health. And so much more that they do, so much more that she mentioned on the radio station. I said, wow. And so right in the service on last Sunday, let me just tell you how God is, because again, I had no intentions of doing this, but right at that moment, God said, so. And I told Lakeisha, I said, give me to the fifth Sunday. I said, because we got to count the money, do all this. And I got a number in my head. Well, I want you to know that number that was in that bucket is the number of this check, what I wanted it to be. And so today, on behalf of the Women of Worth account money, if you sow into the women's ministry, we only ask that you sow $20 a month. It helps us do things like this. It helps us like last Saturday, where we didn't have to hold a registration and we were able to do everything. It helped us do mission work. I'm partnering with our covering church, and we're about to send vitamins over to Ghana. It's so much that the women's ministry is doing. We support the Star of Hope. I'll be going back on November the 18th. There's just so much. So if you sow into the women's ministry, you are a part of this. So I'm going to ask Lakeisha Parker and Sister Cynthia to come and receive this $500 check from the Women of Worth Women's Ministry. Pastor, will you come stand with me as well? All of my ladies, if you sow into the women's ministry, or if you are a part, you believe in a vision, I want you to jump to your feet, because this check is you. Amen. It is you. So this is to the Angels Surviving Cancer. It's just a small what we can do now, but we are committed to do more. I love what I saw on the website. This was a great representative, because that's why I'm sowing, because I heard her. And so I praise God, and I don't want to use the word we are sowing, because this is all of our money collectively from our account. And so I praise God to be able to present this check to both of y'all. And let it be. Thank you, Women of
worth women's ministry. Keep sowing, keep supporting, keep being a part, because it's only up from here.
Good morning. I must say this. 20 years ago, Lakeisha and I worked together at the public library. I was her supervisor. We reconnected 5 years ago with her breast cancer. But God.
But God.
But God.
We are better together. We are better together.
Yeah, but God is a mouthful. What an awesome worship experience on today. Very quickly, we're standing on behalf of the pastoral support team. This month is Women's Month, but it's also Pastor's Appreciation Month as well. Would y'all agree this man and this woman are doing an outstanding job? His word is a phenomenal job leading the Second Avenue Missionary Baptist Church. We just thank God for him. And I believe that the highest call to office, not the president, not the governor, not the mayor, the highest call to office is pastor.
Amen.
Because he's responsible for your soul. And God has blessed him. He does it with such, God has blessed him with such grace and such wisdom to lead this congregation. We just thank God for him.
Amen.
And thank God for Sister Rita as well. Both doing a phenomenal job. Now this is a gift from the pastor, two gifts from his pastoral support. This got Dillard's to one. Dillard's. It's something nice. It looked like. And this one is from the Urshers and Greeters. So can we just stand and just give God thanks for Pastor Morris and Sister Rita one more time?
We're ready. Amen. Amen. I just want to say that I'm humbled. I want to say that I'm humbled. What, you need an announcement? Okay, come on.
Tell you, I'm off script, but when the Lord speaks, the Lord speaks. So we have to let him be whatever it is he's going to be. I had no idea that the class of Jack Yates was going to come in here today. And so it's just confirmation all the way around. This is just amazing. My daughter Maya, this lady, has been amazing, amazing. So in your class, you have a gift. And as I told First Lady today, this is a Barack Obama gift. I'm going to ask Sister Larry to stand, please. I know you don't want to. But this lady, when we talk about how children are being raised and how they need guidance, this lady has been totally instrumental in that fact. Sister Larry worked at one of the schools that all 11 of my children went to. And when I tell you that Sister Larry was a true inspiration and teacher, she was. I had no idea that I would see her today. I had no idea that Pastor them knew her. And when she walked in the door, she said hello. I never get a chance to say thank you for all that you have done. Today, I must say thank you for all that you have done. All of my children and for all of them, they all remember. And the best gift she could have ever given us was the gift of love and support. She wasn't just their teacher, she was their other mother. You hear me? If they was doing something at the school, she comes, she said, now one of yours is up here. I said, I'm on my way. So thank you, Sister Larry. I know this was not part of the plan, this happened to be part of God's plan.
Amen. Come on, let's stand. Let's stand. We're ready. I want to say to the Second Mount Olive family, I'm honored to pastor you. This is a great church with a great history and heritage. And I'm honored to be able to stand in a place where so many great people stood before me. So thank you. Thank you for every gift. Thank you for every kind word. It does not go unappreciated. We love you. And we're grateful that you love us as well. Amen? Amen? Come on, if the Lord has been good to us today, let's put our hands together. Let me speak a rich blessing over your life. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you in your labor and your leisure, when you rise up early and when you settle late, in your laughter and in your tears, in your happy times and when you're sad, until that day that we all sit at the feet of Jesus, where there'll be no sunrise nor sunset. But until then, remember, desperate moments call for desperate measures. God bless you. You are dismissed.